How to find property information. Chemists depend on chemical and physical property data in their research for a number of reasons, including planning experiments and verifying and interpreting results. Finding data is not always easy because there is no one place where all types of data for all substances is located, and it is not always clear where to look or whether you have looked in the right places. A good first stop is one of the major general compilations. However, those resources include only more commonly studied substances and properties. What do you do when you don't find what you are looking for? Here are three steps to help guide you. Step 1. Make sure that you know and understand the compound or substance in which you are interested. Step 2. Know and understand what type of property data you need. Step 3. Once you know both the substance and the property, decide where to start looking for that information. Step 1. Make sure that you know and understand the compound or substance in which you are interested. Be aware that a substance can be identified in many different ways: its structure, its trade name, its common name, its scientific name, its registry number, or its molecular formula. The molecular formula of a chemical substance may even be expressed in more than one way. For example, CH3COCH3 is the same as C3H6O. They just use different conventions for the order of the chemical symbols. A good place to find additional names and identifying information for substances is SciFinder. Another option is Common Chemistry, a freely available subset of more commonly studied substances in SciFinder. Knowing what categories the substance is in can also be helpful because there may be a book or database devoted to that particular type of substance. A few possibilities to consider. Is it a polymer or pharmaceutical? Is it a solid, liquid, or gas? Is it used as an adhesive, a food additive, or a coating? Step 2. Know and understand what type of property data you need. After identifying other names for your substance, the second step is to know and understand what property you are trying to find. The name by which scientists call a property can change over time. As with substances, properties can be known by other synonyms or by symbols. For example, the enthalpy of formation may also be called the heat of formation, or it might be represented by the symbol delta H subscript F. Specifying what type of property, like thermodynamic or optical, is also useful because the information you need may be in a collection that only includes that type of data. Step 3. Once you know both the substance and the property, decide where to start looking for that information. The final step, once you have more thoroughly identified the substance and property of interest, is selecting the best resource. A good way to identify places to look is to consult a compilation of chemical and physical property data sources. Most of the books and databases listed in these guides are available at the University of Minnesota Libraries. Once you have decided where to look, check MnCat Discovery, the University of Minnesota Libraries catalog, to locate the book or database. If you have any questions, please contact your librarian.